Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to PSGA ISD Football. We are at Cabana Stadium in Corpus Christi, where tonight your very own PSGA North Raiders and the Corpus Christi Miller Buccaneers playing an area round championship game. The Raiders are led by their head coach, Marcus Kaufman, while the Buccaneers are led by their head coach, Justin Evans. I'm Javi Martinez, and with me, of course, is my good buddy, Jonathan Gongora. This is a proud production of KTRI, spearheaded by Mark Vasquez and Danny Ramos. And, of course, we have Matt Cortez and Edgar Hernandez manning the camera. So sit back and relax and watch some high school football, South Texas style. Jonathan, welcome to the booth. This is a big one. We've been waiting for this matchup all week. Miller Buccaneers hosting PSG North Raiders.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely going to be an interesting game. Of course, PSG North coming in 11-0. They were the 15-5A district champions last year. They were the regional quarterfinalists, and they lost to the eventual state champions, Austin Westlake. Last week they won by district 41-7. Corpus Christi Miller, of course, coming in 10-1, 6-1. The only loss was to the district champions, Corpus Christi Veterans Memorial. They beat Southwest Legacy 70-34 last week.
So we have Jason Montes here, spotlighted Jonathan. You know, Jason Montes comes in as the District 15-5A district champion in rushing. We're going to need a big game out of Montes and that big bruising running attack.
Yeah, here we have Ale Aparicio coming into this game with 139 completions, 1,444 yards passing, 18 touchdowns in total, 11 on the ground. He's a great runner, Javi, but he can also throw the ball.
And, of course, at number nine, the spearheading the defense, we're going to have the manster, as I like to call him, Danny Garcia, man, amongst boys. He's going to spearhead a tough defensive line that's going to have to do their job this evening, stopping this aerial attack from Corpus Christi Miller. The Buccaneers love to toss it around. He's going to be one of the men that's going to have to put pressure on their quarterback.
And here we have Coach Marcus Kaufman, who's been leading the Raiders last few years, Javi. Last year, he led them to the regional quarterfinals. Coach Kaufman, earlier on this season, says they grew off of last year's loss to Austin Westlake. He said, we're not going to get any taller, but we can get stronger, we can get faster. And I tell you what, he did a great job this offseason with that football team. I expect a great matchup. The defensive, the Raiders are known for their black shirt defense. And so we've seen PSJ North against Edinburgh Vela, and that was a very good Edinburgh Vela team, and they stood toe-to-toe with them, Javi, and of course they ended up winning that game. So I expect much of the same. Of course, as you mentioned, Danny Garcia, he stands 6'1", Javi, 275 pounds.
He's a big boy.
Comes in with 47 solo tackles, and he has 22 tackles for a loss. So we expect a lot from Danny Garcia this game.
And of course here, Jonathan, we see the coin flip. Of course, the Raiders are the visitors this evening, wearing their white unis, silver tops, helmets, and the Buccaneers from Corpus Christi Miller, the home team tonight, wearing their gold helmets and purple unis. So it should be a great event. The Raiders have won the coin toss. They elected to defer.
Yeah, and that's something we've seen, Javi, all year long. Every time they want to toss, they defer. And so, you know, again, PSJ North going to test this Corpus Christi Miller offense right off the bat. And I like that decision from Coach Kaufman. Hey, Javi, but don't be surprised. Again, and I said it last week, we didn't see it, but don't be surprised to see an early onside kick here from PSJ North. Coach Kaufman always has something up his sleeve.
Yeah, Coach Gossman, you know, he likes to gamble. He likes to roll the dice and take every advantage that he can. It's going to be interesting to see what happens here on the opening kickoff. You're absolutely right. I'll tell you what, though, Justin, this is a big game. Of course, this is an area round matchup. The Raiders, District 15-5A, district champions, 10-0, 11-0 after last week's by-district win that got them to area. Of course, Corpus Christi Miller, they have one defeat on the year. They lost a big one to Corpus Christi Veterans Memorial. That cost them a district championship. They're representing District 14-5A as the runner-ups. So big matchup tonight. Of course, the winner will face next week in the regional semifinals, Brownsville Veterans. who put a whipping to Victoria West, I believe 74-56. So Brownsville veteran Chargers await the winner of this game. The Raiders are about to kick off. This should be very exciting. It's old school football by the Raiders. Hard nose football. Run at you, smack mouth. And on the other side, we got the new age aerial attack by the Buccaneers. This should be a very fun game to watch.
Yeah, and I'm wondering, Javi, is weather going to come into effect for both teams? As when we arrived, mm-hmm. It was about 55, 56 degrees. And I told you, the wind chill was about 49. Right now, it feels like it's 50. And I tell you what, that wind is howling. We can hear it inside the box. As we see here, a kickoff. And as I call it, Javi, an early onside kick. And I do believe PSJ North is going to recover.
Well, it's going to be interesting who gets it. And the early indication is correct. You must have a crystal ball. You must be a gypsy on your spare time, Jonathan, because you called it absolutely perfect. The Raiders onside kick, they recover. What a turn of events on the initial play. Not even a play, the kickoff. Raider football.
Javi, and going back last week, Corpus Christi Miller scored on the first play. And, mm-hmm. of course, you don't want to put the ball, you know, to their quarterback's hands, Javi. They use a dual quarterback. It's Brown coming into this game. Excuse me, that's going to be Greenwood with 400 and Moreno with 1,500 yards receiving. So, as we see here, Patient North in the first possession.
So it'll be a big-time run right there. That was Andre Matamoros with the carry. He's wearing number 0. We looked at our roster there as saying, who in the heck just ran that ball? We haven't seen him all year, but actually that's Andre Matamoros switching from 84 to 0. So on first down, Matamoros gets from the 46-yard line all the way inside to the Buccaneer 34-yard line. So 12 pickup. On the first down, second down, not much doing. Testing the heart of the defense to the Raiders, not much. Keeping it on the ground. That was Montes on the carry, as we mentioned. Montes comes into the game as the Raiders' leading ball carrier with 1,389 yards rushing on the year with 12 touchdowns.
And, of course, that offensive line is going to be led by Aiden Sanchez, Jordan Brewster, and Dante Garcia.
Of course, you got Renteria and Vecchio as well. And as we talk about that offensive line, the defensive front right now coming up big after the Raiders on their opening play picked up 12 yards from Andre Matamoros. The Raiders this time lose a yard. They're going to mark forward momentum down at the 35-yard line. So it's going to be a big third down upcoming. It'll be third and 11 from the Buccaneer 35-yard line. The Raiders recovered their onside kick. Quarterback keeper, he's got a lot of running room. That's Aparicio. Aparicio gets tripped up, but not before he gets to the 24-yard line. He needed 11. He picked up exactly 11. Thus, Aparicio, and the Raiders pick up a first down. That'll be their second one.
Yeah, and I think that's going to be a big key factor here, Javi. You know, you really don't see PSJ North run that read option right there. And I think, you know, you show a lot to Corpus Christi on film, and sometimes, mm-hmm. you know, you just got to add a little bit of wrinkles in your offense, as we saw there on third down.
So a new set of downs, opening possession for the Raiders. Raiders have already consumed 2 minutes of this drive. Mishap in the backfield. Fortunately for the Raider offense, that was caught. Miscommunication in the backfield. That was number 21, the freshman Ethan Guerra, finally getting the pitch out. I don't know who exactly Aparicio was pitching that out to, but Guerra is able to manufacture at least 1 yard, so it'll be second and 9.
Yeah, and I think it goes back to what I just mentioned, adding a wrinkle into the offense. Mm-hmm. It looked like that pitch was meant to go to the left, but in all reality, it was actually, you know, he was pitching it to the right off that misdirection, and looking for the Raiders, they were able to hold on to that ball.
So no yards on first down there by Guerra on his initial run of the ball game. Of course, Guerra came into the game with 809 yards rushing. On his second carry, he's going to try to get around the edge. And I tell you what, I don't think that's the way you can approach this game, Jonathan. It's obvious Corpus Christi Miller, the Buccaneers defense, they got speed. They got speed around the edges. You got to go right at them. That time, the Raiders tried to go around the right edge. Nothing there. Loss on the play.
Yeah, right there, they were overloaded to the left side, Javi. And all they're trying to do is just catch Miller in that shift defensively, and of course you toss to that weak side, and you know, In all honesty, Javi, you know, you cannot, as you mentioned, run outside. You're going to have to run straight at these guys.
So on third down, it's a pitch right off left tackle, and the Raiders are going to try to muscle their way up field. It's going to be a gain of 4 to 5 yards. Well shy of the first down, though, that it's going to put the Raiders at the 22-yard line. A gain of 5, fourth down upcoming. About 4th and 8, let's see what the Raiders elect to do here on their opening possession. They've already eaten up almost 4 minutes of the game clock, and I believe they're going to go for it. Perhaps too long for a field goal. This would be about a 40-yard field goal, so they're going to go for it. Do the Raiders. Quarterback keeper Aparicio heads up field, and will he make it? I believe no. The Buccaneer defense comes up with a great defensive stop right there. You know, they lost the ball on the kickoff, on an onside kick. The Raiders were driving, but the Buccaneers defense stifles them on fourth down, just a yard shy of first down, maybe two. The Buccaneers will take over at their own 16-yard line.
Yeah, that's real unfortunate right there. Aparicio, I think he came down just a bit too early. He thought he was at the mm-hmm. first down marker.
First down, they're going to ring it out. Reception is made. Very elusive receiver right there. Lonnie Atkinson with the reception.
Yeah, the Raiders defense have their work cut out with mm-hmm. Atkinson. Stands 6'1", he's a senior, 186 pounds, but we saw him in pregame at Javi making some very acrobatic catches.
He is impressive. That was a 7-yard pass right there from Jaden Brown. And he's going to wing it out again. The reception, and it is fumbled, and I believe the Raiders recover. Yes, they do. The Moreno with the reception for the Buccaneers, but that ball was stripped, and the Raiders, a big turnover in Buccaneer territory. First down for the Raiders.
Yeah, Javi, going back to what we're talking about, that Raider defense has always flown to the ball, and they're flying tonight, Javi. What a great, great defensive stand right there for the Raiders.
So the Raiders with their second possession of the ball game in prime field position. It's a give up the middle. And again, very stout defense by the Buccaneer, just swarming to the ball. Maybe a gain of 2, not much more than that. They're going to move the ball from the 23-yard line where the fumble was recovered up to the 21. Gain of 2, 2nd and 8 upcoming.
Yeah, and that's one thing PSJ North does right there, as we see the handoff to Montes. Mm-hmm. They do a good job of time of possession, Javi. They like to keep the opposing team off the field as much as they can, and they're gonna get drives deep into their opposing team's territory.
Again, just a run. This time by the freshman Guerra gets in past the 20. Maybe they're gonna mark him right down at the 20-yard line. So in the red zone for the first time this evening are the Raiders. It's gonna be 3rd and long, though. They're 1 for 1 on third down conversions, 0 for 1 on fourth down conversions.
I tell you what, Javi, that defensive line for Corpus Christi Miller is very fast and very tough.
It's a big run, and lowering his shoulder is Montes. Montes loves contact, and Montes is going to get more than enough barreling down to the 11-yard line. So big time gain right there of 9 yards by Montes. That'll be the Raiders' 3rd first down of the ball game. They are now 2 for 2 in the ball game on third down conversions.
Yeah, what a great block right there by Dante Garcia. He drove his man about 5, 6, 7 yards mm-hmm. down the field.
The Raiders up to the line of scrimmage once again. And again, another bruising run right at the heart of the defense. Barely forward, knocking people over is a running back for the Raiders. Getting down to the 7, tough 4 yards right there.
That's going to be Montes once again mm-hmm. on that amazing carry.
Montes already with 18 yards on 6 carries. He's been the workhorse right now. Aparicio with 16 yards rushing. Matamoros with 12 on the initial play from scrimmage. And Guerra's gotten 3 carries, but he's in the negative department, negative 3 yards. So they're going to run it again off the right guard, right tackle, testing that left side of that defensive front. And again, I tell you what, you know, the Buccaneers come in giving up a lot of points. I don't see how they do because they are very tough against the run.
Yeah, and you kind of wonder, Javi, if it's the fact that, you know, maybe on this side of town they have a lot of air raid offense over here.
Maybe,
could be the case. As we saw, you know, Corpus Christi veterans, the highlights we're watching from that game, there was a lot of passing back and forth.
So another big third down upcoming. As we mentioned, the Raiders are 2 for 2. Taking his time is Aparicio. Big give up the middle, and just getting tripped up is Montes. Montes falls forward at the 4-yard line. Gains 2. That'll be fourth down upcoming. More than sure they're in field goal range now.
Yeah, I like this call right here. If you are going for the field goal, I like this call. You know, you against this team, you have to take any points
that
they give you.
The Raiders are going to be attempting a 21-yard field goal attempt. And, of course, that is number 42, Diego Maldonado, with the field goal kicking duties. We got a whistle before the kick. The kick appears to be good if it stands. Okay, so before the snap, the Raiders call a timeout. That'd be their first. So with 3:58 to go here in the opening quarter of an area round matchup here in beautiful Corpus Christi, Cabanas Stadium. It is PSJ North 0, Corpus Christi Miller 0. Jonathan, you know, in all honesty, I thought we were going to come in and not a shootout, but we're going to see some quick fireworks. We haven't seen those fireworks yet, but still, this is a very tough ball game.
Yeah, you know, PSJ North, again, going back to what I was saying, Javi, just great, great control of the game. They love to control time. They've had the ball for pretty much the whole first quarter. You know, Corpus Christi Miller has only had the ball for 1 minute. PSJ North has had it the rest of the time of this first quarter. So, you know, again, you know, PSJ North doing a great job as they line up here to go for it, Javi. You know, to me, this is a good call. You know, you want to go for three, but, hey, against a team this good, you got to try. As we
and
see Aparicio
there
here.
It is, Aparicio. The Raiders thought about it, and they take the field goal unit off the field after a Kaufman timeout. Kaufman rolls the dice once again. He is 2 for 2. Raiders take an early lead, 6-0. And Aparicio running from 4 yards out.
Yeah, Javi, as I mentioned, that's what you're going to have to do, especially on those third and fourth downs. If that's what you're going to – if you plan on going for like that, Javi, you're going to have to run that read option. And again, PSJ North has not really ran that zone read option. So that's something different that Corpus Christi is going to have to adjust to. As we see here, the extra point attempt is good. The score stands, Javi. PSJ North 7, Corpus Christi Miller 0.
And, of course, the Raiders on 7 plays, 23 yards after a fumble recovery after a reception. The defensive backs force a fumble recovery, and the Raiders take a 7-0 lead. And, of course, there is 3:54 remaining here in the opening quarter.
How about that call for an onside kick, Javi? I was just kind of guessing that, you know, just roll the dice. You know, you're in the playoffs. You win, you go on. You lose, you go home. So, I mean, as they said in the movie Waterboy, last game of the season, can't hold anything back. You got to come in with that mentality.
You cannot hold anything back. And Kaufman did it. You know, it's interesting. I kind of second-guessed him. And it's easy to do up here in the booth, of course. You know, you got sure 3 points. Take them. I always think the toughest points to get are the first 3 points. And here we're going to see perhaps the replay. And there it is. A fake to Montes.
Yeah.
Montes seals the edge, and Aparicio just scampers in. And Aparicio stares down a would-be tackler. I don't think he should be doing that. That may be costing him later on in the ballgame. A mishap on the kickoff. The Buccaneers get it. And, well, time was called. I'm not sure why. Was there an inadvertent whistle?
See, here's my question, Javi. Was there a fair catch called because of that? You cannot advance the ball like that. And I tell you what, number 8, Stafford. I'm not quite sure what the ref said here. We have our window down here because
it's
cold outside. But I think what it was that fair catch was called.
Yes, and you're absolutely right. Once a fair catch is made, regardless whether you actually make the reception or not, you cannot advance the ball. So it'll be first down on the ground, first time they run the ball. The Buccaneers, and diving forward is the Buccaneer running back. That was number 11, Corey Holmes with the carry. Holmes is going to get close to the first down marker, picks up 9 on first down, up to the 33. So Holmes with 9 yards on the initial run by the Buccaneers are going to keep it on the run again. It is Holmes. Holmes gets tripped up, but not before he gets a first down, tackled at the 37-yard line. So 2 carries, and Holmes already has 13 yards rushing, and that'll be the initial first down for the Buccaneers, and that comes at the 325 mark.
Well, how we got a flag. I think that might be holding, actually.
Yes, so hold the phones, and we're going to bring this one back.
And I want to apologize. It's loud. We have the band in front of us. So we're having a hard time. We're trying to do stats at the same time as that we're calling this game. So my apologies on that, but it was a holding call on Corpus Christi Miller.
Big time run again, this time around the near sideline. And again, that is Holmes, and of course Holmes will get credit with 10 yards on the previous call, and then it'll be a 10-yard penalty getting them back. So Holmes now does pick up the first down quickly up the line of scrimmage, and tripping in the backfield is Holmes. If not, he would have had a lot of running room. Holmes gets tripped up at the 39.
Yeah, Holmes coming into this game, Javi, with 800 rushing yards.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's got 86 carries, 800 yards exactly, 4 touchdowns, 7 receptions also for Holmes for 125 yards. And the ground game is bottled up right at around the 40-yard line. They're going to give the Buccaneers forward momentum up to the 41. Gain of 2. It'll be third down.
I'll tell you what, number 78 from Corpus Christi Miller.
Devastating block.
Yeah, that was
goodness.
Just a monster block.
Wow. Third down, upcoming. Quarterback looks, throws, fires. An incomplete pass. The intended receiver just not able to grab that reception. Overthrown to Atkinson. So Jaden Brown overthrows the receiver. It'll be fourth down, upcoming. Initially, right now, it appears the Buccaneers are going to go for it from their own 41-yard line. On 4th and 7, and they get a free play because of a defensive offsides. Still be 4th down, though.
I honestly think they were setting up to punt there. They were just probably trying to draw them offsides, as we see one of the players from Corpus Christi walk off. So I think that's what it was. I mean, they might have just tried to get him. Mm-hmm. You know, see if they would jump. If not, they'd go into that quick punt.
Well, it worked. They got a free 5 yards. Now they're most definitely going to go for it now. And again, they may have gotten a free play, and they're going to go over the top deep. And again, a fine reception. Bad kism, but caught out of bounds. So 2 penalties offsides. A great job by Jaden Brown, the quarterback of the Buccaneers.
Yeah, and if you're PSJ North, you got to be a little bit more disciplined than that. It's obvious what they're going to do. They go into that freeze count, and so, you know, it looked like maybe PSJ North was sending a blitz from the inside, but you know, they got to be a little bit more disciplined in the front line also.
So that'll be 10 penalty yards on back-to-back offsides for the Raiders. New set of downs. After 2 first downs now, the Buccaneers are going to swing it near the sideline. That was Moreno with his 2nd reception of the ball game. It's about a 4-yard pickup. We call it 2nd and 6 from up here. Ground game. Holmes. Corey Holmes up to the Raider 41-yard line. He has to get to the 39, so he's going to be about a yard shy of the first down. Third down upcoming. And banging himself around a human pinball right there is Corey Holmes. Corey Holmes is going to bounce off a couple would-be tacklers, stays on his feet, gets past the 40 to exactly the 39-yard line, maybe the 38, and that'll be a first down once again for the Buccaneers. That'll be their third. Buccaneers trying to answer the Raiders touchdown as the Raiders lead 7-0 as we approach the 1:15 mark of the first quarter. Big gaping hole up the middle, and that closed quickly, Jonathan. That was a big-time collision.
Yeah, that sure was. Once again, that's going to be number 99, Dante Garcia, in on that tackle. As we see here in replay, and just a simple inside trap, we see number 70 come around and pull to the inside, and a great job right there defensively by the Raiders.
So second and seven upcoming from the 35. And is it intercepted?
Yes, that is, Javi.
Yes, it is. And there is a word, big-time interception right there. Leroy Palacios, he's had a few picks on the seat. Well, they're going to talk it over now. That's why I was kind of, well, we're going to see it here on the replay.
I think they're trying to see if it bounced on the ground, but no, it is. They are going to give him the interception, Javi.
Yeah, he clearly did make the interception, so Leroy Palacios and the black shirt defense forcing the second turnover. That was a big one right there as the Buccaneers were driving. Big time interception. And the Raiders are going to take over at their own 20-yard line after forcing an interception there. And on first down, the Raiders quickly run the ball. Maybe a yard, maybe two, not much more than that. Right now, I think the Raiders just really continue to try to test that defensive front. Here we see on the replay, quarterback keeper Aparicio gets a couple yards, not much more than that. And, you know, and Jonathan, we've talked about this all year long, how strong this Raider offensive line is. But for the first time this year, so far, I think they've met their match. I think this Buccaneer defense is equally as strong, equally as tough.
Yeah, they are. And you know what, Javi? On the flip side, if you're Corpus Christi, you're going to load up the box. You can see right there, they have about nine guys in the box. So, I mean, it's going to be very difficult to run, you know, outside and inside at the same time, you know, because of how many guys are inside that box. So, as we end the first quarter, Javi, one quarter in the books, PSJ North 7, Corpus Christi Miller 0.
So the teams will flip sides, they'll flip fields. The Raiders with the ball, and of course, you know, after one quarter play, it's as even as it can get statistically. The Raiders right now with 49 total yards. The Buccaneers with 45 total yards. Jonathan, there's three big differences you could say in this ballgame. One, the Raiders got the onside kick. Two, the Raiders forced a fumble inside Buccaneer territory, and they converted that into a touchdown. And that's number two. And then number three is the Buccaneers were driving.
Yeah.
And, you know, Leroy Palacios comes up with a gem of an interception. Those are three big things of the game so far. Those are the three biggest plays. And as a result of that, after one quarter, as you just mentioned, it's PSJ North 7, Corpus Christi Miller 0. We've got 36 more minutes of fantastic football here from Cabana Stadium here in Corpus Christi. The Raiders facing a third and long from their own 22-yard line. They're going to keep it on the ground and busting open. And there is a freshman, Guerra, off to the races. Can he outrun everybody? He's going to get to the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Raiders. Ethan Guerra.
Wow,
78
wow.
yards. He busts through the line. It almost seems like he was going to get tripped up. Instead, he keeps on his feet, outruns everybody in the stadium. Guerra with his 11th touchdown rushing of the year. Big-time football from a big-time freshman.
Javi, I'm in shock and awe with that run right there by Guerra. Guerra coming into this season, coming into this game, Javi, has 90 carries for 809 yards and 10 touchdowns. Let's add one more to Guerra's total. Guerra with 11 touchdowns of the season.
Well, I tell you what, he's going to get close to 1,000. Not too shabby for a freshman. Three plays, 80 yards later. The Raiders convert the extra point quickly here in the second quarter with 11:45 remaining before the half. It is now PSG North 14. Corpus Christi Miller 0.
Yeah, as we see here on replay, Javi, you know, and just a misdirection. Here comes that counter on the inside. A great block right there by, I believe that's going to be Dante Garcia. And one missed tackle, Javi, led to that 78-yard run by Guerra. And, you know, credit to number five, Cavanes from Corpus Christi Miller, who tried to chase him down.
Javi, I thought he was going to get him.
Yeah,
he did not.
Initially I thought, but I think that once Guerra saw all that green grass, he stepped on the jets and just took off.
And I think that was Joe Derek Vecchio with the seal block that allowed Guerra to sneak through that offensive line. They've been pounding it. They've been pounding it on the left side. And they switch it over to the right side. They finally got some daylight on the left side. Big time run. The Raiders are looking pretty right now here in Corpus. It's 14-0. Of course, it's an area round matchup. The Buccaneers, you know, second place in District 14-5A. The Raiders, champions in District 15-5A. So it's a tremendous matchup. The winner of this game will play Brownsville Veterans next week in the regional semifinals. So that should be a dandy of a game, but we still got a long way to go here. Kickoff again, muffed, and it's going to bounce out of bounds. Did he touch the player? No, they are saying it did not. That means it'll be a penalty on the Raiders, and the Buccaneers should have good solid field position.
I think that was number 34 from PSJ North with that, you know, amazing hustle. That's going to be Mariscal with that hustle. Mm-hmm. He tried to get down there and keep that ball in bounds.
So the ball will be spotted at the 30-yard line. That's where the Buccaneers are going to have their third possession of the ball game. They look really good on their second possession, but then an interception by Palacio ended that drive. And on first down, again, a steady dose of running. Now, it's interesting now that the Buccaneers kind of went away from that passing game. They're running the ball a lot. I think they're just trying to set up that defense.
Yeah, I think all they're trying. I think you're absolutely correct, Tommy. They're trying to suck in those linebackers, which would allow that passing game over the top to open up. But the Raider defense holding strong right now.
And of course, that was Ethan Greenwood with the carry, his first of the ball game. And on second down, a short gain once again. So a big third down upcoming. This time they go back to number 11, Corey Holmes. Third down. Holmes. Does he get enough? I think he's going to be a yard short. Do we have a penalty flag, though? Holmes gets down to the 39. First down marker sits at the 40. The Raiders are saying a holding call.
I think we have an injured player.
So it will be a holding call as the trainers attend the Buccaneer player who is down with an injury right now. And I believe that was the running back who went down rather awkwardly, Corey Holmes. Corey Holmes, as of right now, has 35 yards rushing on 8 carries. And, of course, Holmes is there. Workhorse, he came into the game with 800 yards rushing and 4 touchdowns.
Yeah, Holmes is averaging 102.8 yards per game, Javi.
Mm-hmm. They're a good-looking running back.
I tell you what, you know, we got here early, Javi. We saw Corpus Christi in pregame, and it's a big team.
They got good size. I tell you what.
We know PSJ North is big, but these guys are huge.
I'm going to say, I think it's fair to say these guys are pretty big. They're pretty intimidating. You know, they got the real pretty gold helmets, dark purple uniforms. You know, they look tough, And they are as advertised. They're putting up a great fight. I think this game is still well in the balance. It can go either way. So after a 10-yard penalty on the Buccaneers, it's going to be third and long now upcoming. That'll be 20 yards of penalties on the Buccaneers now. Shotgun formation for Jaden Brown. Empty backfield. No, excuse me, that is not Brown at quarterback. That's Trevor Long. Trevor Long dumps it off, trying to evade a couple of would-be tacklers and just running out of real estate. After reception, it's Amari Lister. Lister ran about 30 yards, but he ran sideways, nowhere to go. There is a penalty flag, though, on the far sideline at around the 28, so we'll see what that is all about.
I think we might even have a blindside block over there.
Well, there you go. It's going to be declined, as that'll force the Buccaneer punt unit team onto the field. So the Raiders deep man sitting at around his own 40-yard line. Good boot. It's going to hang up in the wind. It's not going to go very far. It's going to land at the 45, but take a tremendous Buccaneer roll. Great job right there by the punt unit flipping the field. So the Raiders will take over at their own 23-yard line as the defense does a job on a three and out. And the Raiders will start at their own 23 with a 14-0 lead with 10-11 remaining here in the first half. Here from Cabanas Stadium, a really pretty stadium, a very, very nice, well laid out athletic complex. I mean, you got your football field, you got a softball field, you got a baseball field, you got a lot of stuff going on. It's really nice. Nice place to be here. Cold weather, though, but that's football for you.
Oh, yeah, it wouldn't be a November game without this weather, Javi. You know, and we were unsure what it was going to be like driving up here. It was that nasty drizzle, and it wasn't cold. We see here in replay, you know, once again, a great job by Montes. And again, that's Dante Garcia, you know, just amazing blocking, just pushing his defender 7-8 yards down the field.
So Montes with 8 yards on that carry. And they're going to keep it on the ground. And again, I think finally we're starting to see that offensive line really starting to lather up, really starting to give their running backs a little bit more room. And that's the thing about PSG North, as we see here on the replay. As you can tell, they're starting to get upfield now. Before it was right at the line of scrimmage, maybe they're gaining a yard or two downfield, and that's enabling the stable of running backs that the Raiders have to pick up a first down.
I think that was actually Guerra on that run, but mm-hmm. Guerra lucky to hold on to that ball. That ball looked like it popped out initially.
It'll be first and 10 from the Raider 35, trying to extend this 14-0 lead before the half ends. On the ground, Guerra showing his athleticism right there. Getting over a couple of defenders. Guerra's going to fall forward. Big pickup of 7. Up to the 42-yard line. So second and 3 upcoming. And this is a play right now. We haven't really seen Aparicio throw the ball at all. Now that we talk about it, all 146 yards on the ballgame right now via the running game for the Raiders. It's a great time to throw, but instead they're going to keep it. And that's a big bruising run for a first down from Montes. And the Raiders inching up close to midfield. They're now with a new set of downs at their own 47. Of course, this drive started for the Raiders at their own 31-yard line after forcing a three and out from the Buccaneer offense.
You know, it's funny you mentioned about Aparicio throwing. You know, I called Coach Kaufman after their win last week, and he says, I know what you're going to tell me. Why did I throw the ball? And I was like, I actually wasn't going to tell you that. I just wanted to tell you congratulations. But he said, you know what, we're just trying to test out, see where we can, you know, maybe switch it up a little bit. We're gonna have a timeout here from Corpus Christi. And so I think what it was, Javi, in my opinion, is that you don't want to show too much on film. You know, you don't want to show too much because you're going to go – you were more than likely going to beat Donna. And, of course, anything can happen, right? Let's not take away credit from Donna because it was a, you know, it was a great game.
They're a solid football team, without a doubt.
But both hard-hitting teams. But, you know, you don't want to show too much on film because, you know, this Corpus Christi team is obviously second place runner-up for a reason. So I think PSJ North did a great job of not showing too much last week and maybe just try to, you know, just show the bare minimum. And we saw it there. You know, they ran that zone option and they've come back with that counter that they're so successful with. And I think PSJ North is doing a great job of controlling the ball, controlling the time right now.
And, of course, alluding back to last week's bi-district championship win by the Raiders, you know, it's 41-7 over the Donna Reds. Donna put up a good fight. They moved the ball at times. They you know, they held the Raiders. They came up with a couple of interceptions on Aparicio, and maybe that's why we haven't seen Aparicio throw yet until he really needs to. But again, you know, the Raiders also, you know, going to last week's game, they had a couple offensive linemen that sat out. They had a couple defensive players. They weren't at a full force last week. And I think this week we're seeing a complete team play. And, you know, we saw film on Corpus Christi Miller. And to be honest, they look very good. And they look really good in person right now. Right now, the upper hand goes to the Raiders. But again, we still got a long way to go. So 8 minutes to go in the first half. Right now, though, the Raiders up 14-0. Given the back row disrupted in the backfield, big job right there by number 30, just shooting in the backfield. Quincy Williams almost forces a fumble there.
Yeah, that ball almost came out, as we see here in replay. That's Guerra once again. Mm-hmm. That's the second time that ball almost pops out. But again, you know, Javi, just as well, I thought they had given him a yard. No, I was going to say as hard as that run was, he still gained a yard or two, but, you know, the Miller defense doing a good job of controlling the line of scrimmage on that play.
Well, they had a run blitz on that one, the linebacker shooting in the gap, and this time they gamble, they miss the wrong hole, and Guerra, again, he fights through the left guard, left tackle slot. Great job right there by Guerra crossing midfield.
Yeah, and again, just that counter on the inside. Mm-hmm. And it looks like what it is, Javi, they can run that counter either way. You know, you can run it a short side or you can run it to the far side. So, you know, great job of Coach Kaufman keeping Miller off balance. But, again, I start to wonder, are the Raiders beating down this Miller front line? Javi, maybe it's just air raid that we see over here in Corpus.
Well, I'll tell you what. The other thing is, the Raiders have had the ball for a long time. They've had the ball for a lot of plays, and eventually that will happen. That, you know, we've always said the Raiders' offensive front is big and strong. They're vicious. I think tonight they have their hands full with a equally strong, equally talented defensive front from the Buccaneers. But time will tell. You know, you keep pounding, and eventually something's going to bust. And we've seen one big one from Guerra already. But again, the Buccaneers have gone into the backfield. They've almost wreaked havoc a couple times. Almost would-be fumbles by the running backs for the Raiders. We're going to have an end around. Nowhere to go. And again, I think that is the toughest thing you're going to have tonight. When Jaden Fuentes tries to get around the edge, I don't think you're going to get around the edge. These Buccaneers, they're fast. They're strong. You know, they can seal the edge.
Yeah, and just a counter play and a great job right there by that defensive secondary from Corpus Christi. But let's go back to the Vela game, Javi. They could not run outside of the tackle box.
Right.
They beat Vela on the inside.
Yes, muscle football.
Just, you know, just in your face. And so I think, like you mentioned, that's what they need to continue doing here.
So it'll be third down, a toss, and keeping it inside the tackles is Guerra. Guerra drags a couple of defenders, still pumping his legs. Great effort right there by the freshman. Guerra's going to get up to the 34-yard line. He's going to be about 2 to 3 yards shy of first down. The first down marker is going to be 2 yards away at the 32-yard line. Here we see Guerra just, again, finding a nice crease, exploiting the hole, and then being very difficult to bring down. So it'll be 4th and 2 upcoming. The Raiders are 1-for-1 in the ballgame. And, of course, that is when Aparicio scored from 4 yards out on the opening the first touchdown of the ball game, giving the Raiders a 7-0 lead. They've extended that lead to 14. Swing toss around the outside and a big time run right there. Well, we were just talking about how they can't get around the edge, but I think if you are going to get around the edge, it's got to be a quick hitter, and that's exactly what they did. Good running right there by Jaden Fuentes, getting around the edge right there.
Yeah, and all that is, Javi, you know, the moment that Aparicio gets to the line, he snaps the ball, mm-hmm. and so you don't really give much time to the defensive front of Corpus Christi to get set or even, you know, attempt to think what's coming at you.
So it was a big 6-yard pickup by Fuentes. Keeps the chains moving, keeps the clock in the favor of the Raiders. 4.5 minutes remaining before the half. Raiders trying to extend their 14-0 lead. And again, just not much doing. Powell finally pushes forward. I'm not sure when the whistle blew. Let's see where they stop the forward momentum. They're going to say at about the 25-yard line.
This could be a 3-yard gain right there. A hard-earned 3-yard gain. And one thing I love about this offensive line from PSJ North, Javi, is that they push the pile forward.
Yes.
They just don't look at the running back. They all get in there and push that pile forward.
Second down. And 7 from the 25. Taking their time at the line of scrimmage is Aparicio and the Raiders. Going into the I formation now are the Raiders. They're going to give it to their deep back with a lead blocker. Just nothing doing. Their great job right there by that defensive front, shrugging off their offensive lineman. That defensive line just collapses in the backfield. Great tackle right there.
I'm not sure if maybe, you know, they lined up incorrectly or if that was purposely where they have Guerra shift late. But it just looked like from the beginning of that play, Javi, they weren't too certain what they wanted to run.
Well, it'll be a loss on the play. That'll be the third tackle for a loss by this Buccaneer defense here in the opening half. As we approach the 3-minute mark, a big third down upcoming for the Raiders. I formation once again. They're going to fake it. Aparicio's going to throw for the first time, or will he? He gets harassed, and that is a fumble. And the Buccaneers are going to recover big-time football right there by the Buccaneer defense. They force Aparicio to scramble. They got to him quickly. They stripped the ball, a strip sack, and the Buccaneers are going to take over. After the Raiders were driving, that's a huge turnover right there. Buccaneers get an opportunity to get on the board. Here we see on the replay, just great job of penetration in the defense. Aparicio drops it. Quickly, the Buccaneers recover it. Buccaneers have some new life as they have the ball now at their own 40-yard line. Each team now has turned the ball over. Buccaneers twice, Raiders once, and quickly up to work are the Buccaneers offensively. They're going to net about 7 yards on that run right there. So, Jonathan, that's the nature of football. You know, you're riding high. You're up 14-0. Looks like you may make it 21-0 before the half. And now the Buccaneers have new life, and they're off and running. Big-time run right there. The Buccaneers are back in action. I'll tell you what, this is a team that we expected to see, and we're starting to find out as they have a new breath of life now. Big time carry right there of 19 yards and a Buccaneer first down. Make that a 20-yard gain up to the 34-yard line. So Buccaneers quickly moving the ball as we're approaching the 2-minute mark. Now the ball after a 3-yard pickup. Second and 8 upcoming for the Buccaneers from the Raider 31-yard line. Stutter step, it loses a couple defenders, and then just barreling over a couple would-be tacklers. My goodness, that's a vicious run right there. That's a big, strong Jaden Brown, bruising running back.
Yeah, Jaden Brown only coming into this game with 200. I'm not sure, is that Brown or Greenwood?
Yeah, it was it's Greenwood, excuse me, Ethan Greenwood with the carry.
He comes into this game with 493 yards. Mm-hmm.
And another big-time run. This time that'll get the Buccaneers into the red zone after an 8-yard pickup up to the 18-yard line of the Raiders. Buccaneers, they still have a couple timeouts. They're hurrying up on offense. They got the Raiders reeling right now. Quarterback throws, tosses. That's caught. A lot of would-be tacklers right there. A lot of silver helmets on the receiver, Moreno. Moreno does a great job of making that reception under heavy pressure, under big coverage. Up to the 12-yard line, gain of 6. They're going to say forward momentum at the 12. Greenwood looking for some running room, and he gets belted at the line of scrimmage. That is a big-time tackle right there. That is big old number 77. Marcus Hernandez just laying the lumber on Greenwood.
Yeah, Hernandez coming into this game with 51 total tackles, 25 solo. You know, I mean, he has 9 tackles for loss in the season, and he's averaging 6.4 tackles per game. And, yeah, I think right there that's a big, big stop right there on third down. You kind of slow down the momentum from Corpus Christi. And again, let's go back to that last possession that PSJ North had. You know, I'm not sure I throw the ball, Javi. You know, it's a gutsy call because you're just trying to catch him off guard, but you're doing such a great job of just, you know, smash mouth. You're just running the ball down their throat, basically. You know, just keep it up. And if you come to fourth down, go back to that read option. But, you know, it's a football game, Javi. You got to take gambles every once in a while. And, hey, for all we know, if Aparicio throws a touchdown there, Coach Scott, it's a great call.
You know, right there, I think you just got to give credit to that defensive front. They dominated on that play. They forced a sack fumble. And on third down, the Buccaneers are going to pick up a first down. Another bruising run of 7 yards up to the Raiders' 5-yard line. And here we see on the replay, Greenwood. I tell you what, I know Montez doesn't shy away from contact. Neither does Greenwood. And I think Greenwood dishes a punishment. Oh, my goodness. And he gets sat on that play. Wow, now this is becoming a football game, folks. This is big-time football. Look at this collision right here.
Yeah, that's – I tell you what, Greenwood's a big guy, Javi, with that. That's a big hit from a small guy. I believe that was number 12.
Jesse Montes.
Yeah, that was Jesse Montes, a brother
of Jason.
Jason Montes.
We just talked about him, and the little bro comes in with a big-time hit. We're going to have a timeout with 17 seconds remaining before the half. I tell you what. You know, as they say, things escalate very quickly. After that interception, you could tell the Buccaneers were kind of down and out. They said, oh, my goodness, we're going to get our butts whipped at home. It's going to be 21-0 before the half. All of a sudden, interception. The Buccaneers are back, and they are fighting hard. And this game has really – I'll tell you what, this game was on a level of 10. You know, it was about a 6-7. It's gone up to about an 8 or 9. I mean, it is getting physical out there.
Yeah, and that's what you want, Javi. You know, and this is right here. This is where PSJ North defense can come make a stand right here. You could say, hey, we're not scared of you. Keep running the ball. We're going to make a stop. Both teams with one timeout. If Corpus Christi does not get a first down, or excuse me, does not score a touchdown right here, they're going to be forced to kick a field goal, especially with one timeout left.
Yeah, it's second down, as you mentioned. It's second and goal. With the timeout, you can run. You can run or pass. You can do either one. It's going to be interesting to see. They split out the Raider defense. Last second adjustments. Plenty of time on the play clock. We're barely at 17 seconds. It's a gift. Greenwood lowers his shoulder, and is he in?
I actually think he fumbled the ball at the goal line, Javi.
Well, they're going to say he's down. And was it a fumble? Well, right now he did not get in the end zone. I don't know if contact was made. And the ball carrier will be down at the one. I'll tell you what, high drama here in Cabanas Field, Cabanas Stadium. It looked like maybe the ball got loose. He was definitely down by contact before, or at least the ball was down before he got into the end zone. So it'll be third and goal from the one. 8 seconds remain. And here we see the replay, John. Let's see what we see.
Yeah, all that is just a bounce back run. And man, Javi, he's such a big guy. And no, he was actually down. And, yeah, the ball
didn't
come out.
The ball came out.
I think he was already down.
Yeah, we had a bad angle there. We couldn't see. The ball carrier's back was to us, so we'll never know. And in either case, it's the official's call that stands. It'll be third and goal from the one. Miller takes the field. Raiders still in their huddle. The Raiders break after the timeout. It's all or nothing here on third down, I believe, for the Miller Buccaneers. Just as their helmets are going for gold here. Raiders, can they make a defensive stop? Black shirts, gold helmets. It is going to be a touchdown for the Buccaneers. Greenwood just plows into a defender at the goal line. Winning that battle easily is Greenwood and the Buccaneers, and they're right back in this ball game. It is now 14-6 pending the extra point.
Yeah, Javi, what a monster run right there by Greenwood. Nobody was going to stop that guy, as we see him just, you know, coming off the field with his championship belt. And I tell you what, you're absolutely correct. After that interception, after that fumble, Corpus Christi Miller with some new life in him.
60-yard drive, 12th place, kept off by Greenwood from 1 yard out. And again, as we mentioned, Kaufman with some gutsy calls. The Buccaneers go for it on third and go from the one, the extra point will be successful. So with 4 seconds remaining here before the half, it's a ball game, folks. Area round matchup. It's a beautiful one. PSG North 14. Corpus Christi Miller 7.
Yeah, Javi, you know, the statistic-wise, mm-hmm. you know, both teams, you know, pretty evenly matched. You know, PSG North with 179 yards, total offense, 179 on the ground. All the yards coming on the ground.
Yes.
Corpus Christi, 110 total yards with 91 coming on the ground and 19 in the air. You know, if you look at the time of possession, PSG North has held the ball for 15 minutes to Corpus Christi 8. But, you know, Corpus Christi with that quick tempo offense right there. And we hadn't really seen that. We had seen them kind of line up, take their time running a play. But I think that's where PSG North kind of struggles defensively is once you try to catch them, you know, just mm-hmm. off balance basically.
Right. And the interesting thing, Jonathan, is as you mentioned, that fumble recovery on that sack was huge. Buccaneers take that turnover. They turn them into points, make the score 14-7. And guess what? The Buccaneers are going to receive the ball to start the second half. So Lady Momentum has shifted quickly from the Raiders to the Buccaneers. And we're going to see exactly what we can have happen. Oh, no, and, well, excuse me. Since the Raiders got the onside kick, the Raiders will receive. I just lost my mind. That's how good this game is. Well, we got 1 minuscule second remaining before the half. It's been a great one. Of course, PSG North representing District 15-5A as district champs. Corpus Christi Miller representing District 14-5A as district runner-ups. As advertised, this has been a whale of a game. And the winner, of course, will advance to the regional semifinals to face Brownsville Veterans, who won last night. They beat Victoria West, so they are Brownsville Veterans. I'm sure they're some of those kids, some of those coaches, either they're here or they're watching our live broadcast here with KTRI. So that'll do it, folks, from Corpus Christi. Cabana Stadium, we got one half in the books. We're going to head down to the halftime entertainment with PSG North leading 14-7. Enjoy the halftime entertainment. We'll see you after the break. Well, folks, welcome back to Corpus area round matchup between the host Corpus Christi Miller Buccaneers and the PSG North Raiders at the half. It is the Raiders 14, the Buccaneers 7. Jonathan, it's been a well-played game. A lot of stuff going on, a lot of excitement. We've had everything from big runs, big passes, interceptions, fumbles, onside kicks. It was an interesting, tremendously well-played first half. We got 24 more minutes to go, Jonathan. It's going to be very exciting here.
Yeah, Javi, you know, it's definitely an interesting game. You know, it was such a quick first half that we didn't even realize that halftime had already come and gone. Time of possession, Javi, let's talk about that first. PSJ North, 15 minutes and 8 seconds. Corpus Christi, 8 minutes and 52 seconds. You look at team totals, PSJ North with 179 yards. Total yards and on the ground. If you look at Corpus Christi Miller, 110 total yards, 91 on the ground. So it's a pretty evenly matched game, Javi. I think Miller got a lot of momentum off of that fumble by Aparicio. But, you know, luckily for PSJ North, he gets to receive the ball here in the second half.
Well, and, of course, the Raiders do receive the ball. Of course, you know, the Raiders stole a possession, so to speak, in the first half as they got the onside kick. And we are underway. A little pooch kick is going to be fair caught by the Raiders. And, of course, that was Leroy Palacios, who has an interception in the ball game. So the Raiders are going to have good, solid field position here to start the second half. Of course, as we mentioned, it's 14-7. We got a half to go, 24 minutes of exciting football coming at you. Of course, it's a prod production of KTRI. I'm Javi Martinez, Jonathan Gongora. The Raiders are going to have the ball to start the second half at their own 38-yard line. Each team has had four possessions. The Raiders have forced two turnovers. The Buccaneers have forced one. First down from scrimmage to start the second half. It's a keeper, a lead block by Montes. Aparicio follows Montes. Good job right there by the Raiders, picking up about 4 to 5 yards. Good gain on first down. Second down upcoming for the Raiders.
Yeah, and I think we're going to see a lot of that this second half, obviously. As we see there on the replay again, Aparicio with that quarterback keeper, a design quarterback keeper at that. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what PSJ North is going to have to do this second half, is just try to keep the ball away from Miller as much as they can, because as we saw in that last possession from Miller, as we see here, that's Montes on a nice run.
So Montes explodes through a crease on that offensive line, gets past midfield, as we see here, bursting through, looking, trying to evade some defenders, finally gets tripped down at about the 39-yard line. And a big-time run of 18 yards right there by Montes. Montes, a workhorse in the evening for the Raiders. 12 carries, 58 yards rushing. Quickly back to the ground game again are the Raiders, pounding their way up to the 36-yard line. A short gain of 3, but nonetheless a pickup of 3. Second and 7 upcoming.
Yeah, and Montes already with 61 yards. Ethan Guerra with 101 yards. Of course, 78 came from that long touchdown run from him. And again, just this PSJ North front line, Javi, just I honestly think they're dominating the trenches right now.
Well, the first half, they appeared to be doing extremely well when they had a 14-0 lead. And then the turn of events when a fumble occurred, but the Raiders right now continuing to pound the ball on the ground. A couple more yards, inching closer to that first down. Big third down upcoming for the Raiders. It'll be 3rd and 4. Of course, the first down marker sits at the Buccaneer 29-yard line. Ball at the 34. The toss around the outside. Montes, it loses the defender, stays on his feet, drags one past the 20. Into the red zone, but we're going to have a penalty that sits at the 32-yard line. So hold the phones. The play stands. It's a first down Raiders. If not, that's holding, and it will be.
Yeah, that's one of those very, very seldom offensive penalties from the Raiders, mm-hmm. And I think they're going to actually get Garcia on that hold.
So the penalty be from the line of scrimmage from the 33. It was 2nd and 7.
I actually think they're going to get Guerra on that hold there.
So the ball get pushed back up to the 47-yard line.
And again, if you're PSJ North Harvey, you don't want to be in these long down opportunities. You don't want to be in these long down situations because, you know, you've already attempted to throw the ball once. As we see here, a counter by the Raiders.
So the counter play by the Raiders, actually the ball was spotted at the 43-yard line, excuse me. And the Raiders get past the initial yard marker and down to the back to the line of scrimmage at the 39. So it'll be 4th and 10 upcoming. So the Raiders, they pick up a first down. They had a big play that was called back due to holding. And after that, the Raiders punt unit takes the field. So the Buccaneers do the job. They don't have anybody deep, though. They're anticipating possibly a fake here. It's a good snap. A good punt. The Raiders trying to pin the Buccaneers deep, and they will not be able to as the ball sails into the end zone for a touchback. So the Buccaneers defense, they bend a little. They get that stop that they needed. Buccaneers take over at their own 25-yard line. Well, John, this is where it's going to get interesting. You know, the Raiders developed a 14-0 lead. A lot of cushion right there. It got cut in half right before the halftime, with 4 seconds to be exact. And now the Buccaneers are going to get their first crack here in the second half.
Yeah, I expect the Buccaneers to go into that high-powered offense that we haven't seen yet. We've seen a lot on the ground from Brownwood, but I expect the Buccaneers to throw the ball here. But on the first play from scrimmage in the second half of the Buccaneers, it's going to be a run, and I believe that's going to be
Corey Holmes. Yes, correct. Corey Holmes and, of course, Ethan Greenwood have been the two primary running backs for the Buccaneers here in this ball game. But going nowhere, actually going backwards, is Holmes, tackled at the 18-yard line. That'll be the first tackle for a loss for the vaunted black shirt defense. 2nd and 12 upcoming. Keeping it on the ground are the Buccaneers. This time a lot more running room. Great open field tackle right there.
A late penalty flag.
By Leroy Palacios making the tackle. And we do have a late penalty flag. Let's see what this is about.
Might be a late holding call.
I think they're deciding now where the spot foul occurred. The penalty flag sat at the 24-yard line. The ball carrier fell out about that spot, so let's see if it's a spot foul.
Got a sideline interference there.
So it'll be a sideline infraction if we heard correctly. If we didn't, we apologize. We got almost soundproof windows here. Beautiful complex here. We can't hear anything the official is saying. In either case, it's 3rd down from the 12. Going deep, going for it all. Moreno just barely gets off his fingertips. My goodness, a big time pass right there. Jaden Moreno was streaking. That may have been a big touchdown pass for the Buccaneer offense. Instead, it's a near miss, and the Buccaneers are going to be forced to punt after a 3 and out.
Yeah, Moreno coming into this game with 1,005 yards receiving, 91.4 yards per game, and that's all he's known for. He's known for catching the ball, and he wishes he'd have that one back, Javi, as the Raiders defense forced the Buccaneers into a punting situation.
Yeah, and of course, that was a pretty pass from Jaden Brown. He's got 1,727 yards passing coming into the game with 29 touchdowns, only 2 interceptions. And a great job by the special teams of the Buccaneers. They flip the field over, and the Raiders will take over at their own 40-yard line. So the defensive units do the job, respectively, for each team on the opening positions, and both teams forced to punt. The Raiders right now winning the battle of field position as they will have the ball for the second time in the second half at their own 40-yard line with 7:36 remaining in the third quarter. Right now the Raiders clinging on to a 14-7 lead. Of course, it's an area-round matchup. Prop production of KTRI. Winner of this matchup will face Brownsville Veterans in the regional semifinals next week. Time and place to be determined later, but right now the issue is still at hand, and there's a lot of fighting going on right there. There you see big old Aiden Sanchez wrestling, trying to get a pancake block.
Yeah, and you know, in his defense, Javi, all he's doing there is playing to the whistle blows.
Yes.
I mean, the whistle hadn't blown, so why?
So we'll have no gain on the play, and then we're going to take a little timeout here, an injury timeout. And here we see on the replay.
I agree. I think that was actually
Aparicio kept it. Yes.
Yeah, that was actually a read option right there by Aparicio.
So that's the one thing we've been fortunate this evening. We haven't had too many injury timeouts. I believe that is just the second one. Both have been Miller players. The first time, of course, a Miller player got up on his feet. He returned to the game, and we hope we see the same situation occur here. I think this time it just may be a cramp. And, you know, John, these kids, I got to commend these kids. These kids, you know, we're in South Texas. We're used to playing in about 80, 90-degree weather. It's cold. The wind chill factor probably has it in the mid-40s. The wind's gusting 15, 20 miles an hour from the northeast. But it's football. It's football weather. It's 53 degrees, but I'm sure it feels more like 47. And a round of applause there for that young man. He's walking off on his own 2 feet. So we're going to resume play. It's going to be second down and 10 for the Raiders from their own 40. Each team has had the ball once. Each team came up empty offensively. The defense really starting to flex their muscle here in the second half. It's been a well-played football game. Full backfield for the Raiders. Aparicio with a naked run around the right side. He's got a lot of blockers in front of him. Uses his blockers wisely. The Buccaneers trying to strip the ball away from Aparicio, but Aparicio with a firm grip barrels down to the 36-yard line. Great play call. Even a better run by the quarterback.
Yeah, what a great play design right there, Javi. As we saw a replay, it's just a fake toss, and Aparicio literally turned all the way around and kept it on that far side, and a great job right there. I believe that's going to be number 14 out there, lead blocking Valdez.
24-yard pickup for Aparicio. Aparicio now on 7 carries, has 49 yards rushing. Of course, Ethan Guerra leading the pack with 101 on a big 78-yard touchdown, and there we see another pancake block. That was big old number 68 getting the job done for the Raiders.
It's Dante Garcia once again.
Yeah, he's tough. I tell you what, these guys are nasty up front. These are the nasty boys. Good block right there. Guerra, the freshman, adding to his game-leading rushing total. Moves the ball up to the Buccaneers' 31-yard line. Second and mid-range, second and 5 to be exact for the Raiders. Aparicio tosses it outside, bottled up in the backfield. Great job right there. A lot of gold helmets on the ball here in the backfield. That's going to be the 4 tackle for a loss by this very good, very aggressive defense from the Buccaneers.
And Corpus Christi not too happy there. I think they thought maybe somebody jumped a little, was a little bit too antsy there. As we see, that was Guerra running into Montes. A big third down here for PSJ North.
It'll be third and 7 from the Miller 33-yard line. Again, full backfield. They're going to run that play once again, and again, it's going to work. And Aparicio stays on his feet, and he's going to pick up a first down. Aparicio barrels into a defender, and Aparicio is going to get into the red zone up to the 19-yard line. He needed 7. He picks up 14. And Aparicio, he's looking good. They come back to that play once again. Aparicio with great athleticism, jumping over a tackler, and then gets bumped out of bounds. So the Raiders making some noise here on their second possession of the third quarter with 5:17 remaining. The Raiders in striking distance trying to extend their 14-7 lead.
Yeah, going back to that last play, a great job right there by number 63, Esteban Flores, mm-hmm. Javi getting out there, lead blocking for Aparicio. We see here, that was Montes on the carry. He's going to give about 5 yards.
And actually, that's Agustin Renteria, 63.
Excuse me, yes, Agustin.
Yes. I may be mistaken. I think that's
think
Renteria.
Two number 63.
Yeah, I think it's Renteria, though. He did a fine job last week. So at the 14-yard line, 5-yard pickup. The Raiders now with 257 yards of total offense, all 257 via a fierce running attack. Aparicio outflanks everybody. It's off to the races, and he will get into the end zone. Aparicio extends the Raiders' lead. Good time running. Aparicio taking the team right now on his back, getting the Raiders into the end zone.
Javi, as I mentioned, Aparicio coming into this game with only 85 carries, 605 rushing yards. Aparicio already with 77 with back-to-back 14-yard gains. A great job right there by that front line from PSJ North, and an even better job by Aparicio.
Yeah, Aparicio last week he had 42 yards rushing, scored a touchdown. So that'll be his third touchdown in the playoffs this year, and the extra point will be good. And just like that, with 4:27 remaining here in the third quarter, it is the Raiders 21, the Bucks 7.
I mean, and let's go back and talk about this offensive line for PSJ North. You got Joe Derek Vecchio, as we see here on replay. Once again, a great job by Aparicio. And again, Javi, that zone read option, that inside zone read, and Aparicio does a great job of running it.
And I think the beautiful play on that was they kept pounding the ball to the right, to the right, to the right, and this time they mixed it up. They went to the left, unsuspecting was the defense. Aparicio uses his speed, his quickness, jolts in for a touchdown, and the Raiders right now, they once led 14-0. Buccaneers cut that lead in half right before the second period ended. At the half, it was 14-7. Now we sit at 21-7. It's getting late very early here. It's 4:27 remaining in the third quarter. Raiders now with 271 total yards. The Buccaneers with 113.
And going back to what I was going to say, Javi, look at the size of that offensive line for PSJ North. You have Joe Derek Vecchio. You know, at 280, you got Aiden Sanchez, 245. You got Dante Garcia, 280. Agustin Renteria, 260. And Jordan Brewster at 305. Everybody usually pretty much stands over 6 feet.
Yeah, that's big. If my math is correct, that's definitely over a 1,000 pounds. That's some big boys. That's some hefty meat. Grade A quality because they do a tremendous job of blocking.
And this is the second time we see a kick out of bounds. Mm-hmm. But I think, Javi, if this is actually a smart decision to kick it out of bounds. And, of course, you know, that wind is blowing. That wind is gusting. As we can hear it in here. But why put the ball in Holmes' hands? If Holmes has a lot of speed, he has 800 yards rushing on the season. So I think I'd keep doing that and force him to beat you on the ground.
Yeah, it's kind of smart. Force him to start at the 30. You give him a good solid field position, but you never know. They can break a big one. Make him go the distance of the field. 70 yards is what the Buccaneers need to traverse here to cut the lead in half and answer the Raider touchdown. And on first down, the Buccaneers are going to keep it on the ground. Gain one, second and nine, upcoming.
That's the first time we see Brown run that ball. Comes in with 215 rushing yards.
The Buccaneers now with 95 yards rushing. Their leading ball carrier is Greenwood, 48. Holmes has 46, and that is a good toss and reception made. And I was starting to wonder when we were going to see Lonnie Akism make a reception, and he finally does. He's an electrifying player. So from the 31 to the 47, a 16-yard pickup, and that'll be a first down. That is the seventh of the ball game for the Buccaneers. We're going to have a timeout here.
Well, I think we're going to have, that's a legal formation.
Yes. Yeah, I didn't see the penalty. It must have been thrown in the backfield. And, of course, there's a 5-yard penalty against the offense. So it'll be first and 15 now for the Buccaneers from their own 42-yard line. Of course, they got to get across midfield. They got to get all the way to the Raider 43-yard line for a first down. It was just under 4 minutes to go, 3:48 remaining here in the third quarter. A tremendous effort from both teams here in area round matchup. Big-time football in South Texas. And after getting back to the initial line of scrimmage, the running back gets bent backwards. They're going to give him forward momentum to Greenwood at the 47-yard line. Pick up a 5. Maybe 6. It'll be 2nd and 9. We're going to have another stop in the action here.
I think once again we're going to have a legal formation or a false start. Javi, and going back to Atkinson, I do believe he has committed to Sam Houston University.
Mm-hmm.
So
yes.
It just goes to show his athleticism. Coming in with over 1,100 yards receiving, you know, he averages 113 yards per game.
Yeah, he's a good-looking receiver. I've seen some highlights on him, and I've seen him on offense. I've seen him on defense. Good-looking kid. Quarterback drifts, plenty of time, looking, trying to buy time, and finally bottled up. That is a coverage sack right there. A great job by the Raiders secondary. They finally get to the quarterback. Brown gets dropped in the backfield at the 40-yard line. Big-time loss right there. Great effort from the front rush of the Raider defense. And here we see the quarterback just looking, can't find anybody. Finally, the pocket completely collapses. Big old number 77 with the tackle. And number 73 joining in on the party. And, of course, that's Marcus Hernandez and Salvador Sanchez. And we're going to have another penalty on the turf here. And I think it's going to go, well, let's see. They're talking about it this time. Well, the Raiders being a bit overzealous there, offsides. And that's the third time the Raiders are going to be called for an offsides this evening. So it'll be 3rd and long from the 36. Running out the defense are the Buccaneers. Just 3 down linemen. Quarterback, and he's going to get flushed. And is that a fumble or an incomplete pass? They're going to say an incomplete pass. A tremendous job right there. Number 6, just in a heartbeat, Mikey Gonzalez. He's done it all year long. The junior defensive back wreaking havoc. Incomplete pass. 4th down for the Buccaneers upcoming.
Javi, that's what you call great defensive scouting right there. Nobody from PSA North panicked.
No.
They knew right away what was coming. And it looked like just a design draw or even like they were trying to go deep on this right side. I think they were actually going for Atkinson. A great job defensively right there by Gonzalez.
4th and behind the chains, looking for it all. And there's a pass. It's caught. Atkinson, and he lunges forward. Is it enough for a first? I think that last second effort, wow, what gamesmanship. That's a true player right there. I believe that's enough for a first down as we see Atkinson walk off back to his position. Great job on 4th down. Great execution. Buccaneers continue to ramble down the field. Now from their own 42, quarterback keeper. He's got a lot of running room. Tucks, and he gets hit hard from the Raiders. Taking out his feet there right at his ankles. Dangerous tackle. Quarterback Brown gets up quickly, though, at the 35. 2nd down. This time we have the new quarterback, Trevor Long. They've been mixing it up, and we're going to have a big-time hit on the quarterback. That's going to be roughing the passer.
Yeah, I want to say that that's going to be on Dante Garcia. And I think going back to that sack, Javi, the previous on that previous play, the referee had already warned him to be careful with that because he's coming in late on there.
Well, that's a big 15-yard penalty against the Raiders. And again, you know, they were offsides. That's 5 yards, 15 yards here on a late hit on the quarterback, a very big hit on Trevor Long. Trevor Long able to withstand, gets up without any problems. Now the ball will sit at the 20-yard line.
I think that was actually on Marcus Hernandez.
So Marcus Hernandez. And is that a touchdown grab? No. The reception was made by Gadkissum, but wow. I tell you what, I saw him. I even, you know, shrugged at you. Did you see that in the warm-ups? I couldn't believe the catch he made in warm-ups. He just made even a better catch. Of course, it was out of bounds. It won't count, but still, highlight reel stuff right there. That's athleticism, buddy.
Javi, that's catching it at the highest point right there. You know, wow. Even though it's incomplete, you know, as we see here once again on replay, just, you know, a great catch, you know, and a great defensive effort right there.
Back on the ground are the Buccaneers, and the Raiders defense gives up a few yards, maybe about seven. Good pickup right there. They're going to spot the ball at the 14-yard line for a six-yard pickup. Third and four upcoming with a minute 10 remaining in the third quarter. It is getting very, very interesting. High drama. Pass outside. A reception. Atkinson cannot get away from his defender. Great job right there by Andre Matamoros making the tackle. It's going to be short of the first down, maybe about 2 yards shy. Pickup of two. Excuse me, pickup of four. It'll be fourth and two as we're going to address another injured player. And there we saw on the replay, just a great job right there. After the reception was made by the secondary, Matamoros making a quick tackle on a very strong, elusive runner.
Yeah, we really haven't seen Matamoros at all on defense this year. So, you know, Matamoros usually, you know, gets mixed in at running back every once in a while, and he'll play that slot receiver.
Right.
And so Matamoros doing a great job right now defensively for the Raiders.
So it'll be an injured player coming off the field once again for Miller. That's always a great sign, as we always say. Little banged up, but not injured. He'll come back. These kids are resilient, that's for sure. 47 seconds remain here in the third quarter. And again, high drama occurring once again. It'll be fourth and two. Of course, the Buccaneers are going to go for it. High snap, direct snap. And is he going to get it? Second effort. Is it going to be enough? They're going to mark him perhaps right at the 10-yard line. It's going to be up to the refs. And I think he's short. The Raiders are celebrating. And I think this is going to call for a measurement. I think he's maybe a nose short, but who knows? This is huge, folks. This is huge right here. And, yes, they're saying it'll be the Raiders getting a defensive stop. They're jubilant. Here we see on the replay, great job right there by number seven, Steven Garza hitting the Wildcat quarterback in the backfield, lunging forward where the Buccaneers have come in about inches short. Talk about a game of inches, Jonathan. That's the difference sometimes between a win and a loss. Raiders come up with a defensive gem. They're going to hit great field position.
Yeah, and unfortunately right there for Corpus Christi, you take off 3 minutes and 50 seconds from the clock, and you don't score. So a great job right there defensively for the Raiders. As we see here, Montes on the carry, going to gain about 2 yards.
So officially they'll give Montes three up to the 13. And that may be the final play of the third quarter. And it will be, as both teams are going to flip sides. Well, folks, a proud production of KTRI, but an even better matchup here in the area around in the Coastal Bend area in Corpus Christi. It is PGA North 21. Corpus Christi Miller, the Bucks, the Buccaneers, 7.
Javi, I think with the situation here, and I said it before, and I'm going to say it again for Corpus Christi, is that when you're not used to seeing, you know, a team just run it down your throat the way the Raiders have been, it's difficult to stop because, of course, defensively you prepare all season long for a spread offense, and I don't know if that's the case. And I'm just assuming because we saw, you know, the film for Veterans Memorial. What did we see? A lot of spread offense.
Yes.
We see You know, Corpus Christi Miller, a lot of spread offense. So right. I don't know if that's the trend here. As we've seen it, even back at home, we see the trend that a lot of people go to spread and very few teams run the ball like the way the Raiders do. So it could be a big difference maker, too. You're not used to seeing that all season long.
Yeah, and it's just a different style of football, different area, different style. And, you know, right now the upper hand, I've always said, Jonathan, I'm an old believer in old school football. You've got to run to win. You've got to be able to run the ball to win. Big games, you got to establish that offensive line. You got to be able to do that. Right now the Raiders have done that, and you flip it over. The Buccaneers are doing it themselves. They just got stopped by inches. So it hasn't been that the Buccaneers haven't been successful this year, tonight. It's just been that they've come up just on the short end of luck.
That's going to be Jaden Fuentes right there on that carry.
It'll be second. It was second down, and Jaden Fuentes is going to be about a yard shy, getting up from the 13 up to the 20. Well, again, it appears the Raiders started their position at the 11-yard line. Of course, it was on the far side of the field. So it'll be third and one upcoming from the 20 for the Raiders here in the final period of a well-played area round matchup. Area round champions is at stake tonight, and the Raiders pick up a first down with a bruising run right there by Fuentes up to the 26-yard line, a gain of 6. First down for the Raiders, and of course, awaiting in the regional semifinals will be Brownsville Veterans. They won a big game last night over Victoria West.
I think that Montes could have actually popped that outside.
Yes.
And instead, he chose to initiate the contact right there.
So it'll be first down, and 1 minute has already been consumed by this Raider offense. We've got 11 minutes to go in the ball game. As we sit right now, it's 21-7 in favor of the Raiders over the Bucks. Aparicio fakes a handoff, keeps it on the read option. Nowhere to go. Great job defensively by the Buccaneers. They sniff it out, not fooled at all. In fact, that's going to be a tackle for a loss back at the 25. That's the fifth tackle for a loss for the Buccaneers defensively.
You know, I won't be surprised to see PSJ North start running the plays with about 5 to 4 seconds on that play clock, Javi.
Yeah, right now they got 14 as they break the huddle. They're going to casually walk up to the line of scrimmage. They get set at about 6 seconds. And they're going to snap it at about 3. It's a give. And again, great job by the defense of the Buccaneers. They're getting the job done. And we see a late push. That could go against the Raiders. And if it does, that spells big-time trouble. It's going to be third and very long.
Yeah, you got to keep your composure in that situation right there, Javi. Especially knowing, you know, not only what's at stake, but the score. Mm-hmm. You're up 21-7, and you don't want Corpus Christi Miller to get any sort of momentum.
Well, it will be a big-time infraction against the Raiders offensively. It's a dead ball foul, so the play will count. They're going to push the ball back all the way to the 13-yard line. Third and a mile. First down marker sits at the Raiders' 36-yard line. It's going to be third and 22 to be exact. This is where you got to be careful. Pick up what you can, punt the ball, hope for the best. Of course, the Buccaneers should have great field position if indeed they do force a punt. Aparicio off to the races, though, and Aparicio has other plans as he streaks down the far sideline at the 30. Can he withstand it? The 10, the 5, touchdown Raiders on a 3rd and 22 after a personal foul. Aparicio turns the stadium upside down. 87 yards later, the Raiders are in the end zone again.
Wow, Javi, I'm blown away. What a play call. Of course, you're just trying to get as much as you can.
I just said, you know, be safe. Pick a 5, punt, hope, lie on your defense. No, sir. Aparicio said, you know what? I got this, gentleman. And he ran for a big touchdown. There we see the fans. We see the sidelines of the Raiders before they kick this extra point. Big-time play by Aparicio. 87 yards. My goodness.
I mean, I think that just might have done it right there. Even just the fact that you make a great defensive stop, Javi. You know, it's third and long.
Yeah.
You have a costly penalty. We see here on replay again. Just a great job by that front line and a good job right there by Aparicio recognizing where the hole was. And, you know, Aparicio almost lost gas at the end. But I tell you what, when you have adrenaline rushing through your body, Javi, you know when no one's in front of you, you're going to go score.
And initially it looked like Aparicio was about to pass, at the very least going to looking to pass. And instead he saw a crease. He exploited it. He burst through it, used his speed, his endurance kicked in at the end, as you mentioned. Wow, what a run on 3rd and 22. That's a backbreaker right there. And the Raiders, you know, you got to go back to that defense, the black shirt defense. It was 4th and 2 in the red zone. The Buccaneers fell inches short of picking up a first down, and the Raiders took over on downs. Just 6 plays later, 89 yards that the Raiders drive on 6 plays. Big one, 87-yard touchdown by Aparicio. Aparicio with a big night. The Raiders kick off with a 28-7 lead with 9:27 remaining in the ballgame. Aparicio now has 154 yards rushing on the evening, leading all ball carriers.
Yeah, a career game for Aparicio, yeah. Javi. I don't think he's ever rushed for this many yards. And again, it's just a testament of to what I've mentioned before in the past. Coach Kaufman does a great job of putting the ball in his athletes' hands, and he's trusted Aparicio all night. There's been plenty of times
definitely.
We've seen him on 3rd and 4th down, keep the ball, and yeah, Javi, just a great job.
It'll be 1st and 10 from the 25 for the Buccaneers, looking to pass. It's a long one, streaking receiver, and that's going to be overthrown. Atkinson was the intended receiver. I believe the quarterback there was Trevor Long.
Yeah, I think we're going to start seeing a lot of desperation throws here, Javi. And if I'm PSJ North, I'm just running a 2-deep safety and covering Atkinson over the top and Moreno on the other side.
Mm-hmm. Looking to pass once again, and this time keeping it. And I may have been mistaken. I believe that is Jaden Brown, the quarterback. I know they've been mixing him up a couple times. Third down, 3rd and 5. Pass outside. Goes through the receiver's hands. Almost intercepted. It's going to fall incomplete. 4th down. And 5 upcoming from the 30. And decision time now for Coach Evans. And I think you got to go for it right now. You're down by 3 scores, less than 9 minutes remaining in the ball game.
Yeah, I mean, coming into this game, you know, Corpus Christi Miller scoring 541 points this season.
So a big-time play on 4th down. That'll keep the sticks alive. A bullet, a dart thrown to his receiver. And that'll be more than enough yards for the first down. So the Buccaneers move the ball. They pick up 7 big yards right there. They needed 5. They pick up 7 on that pass completion. And looking to throw, looking for more, going over the top. It's a pretty pass for Atkinson. And Atkins just could not get it. I think we're going to call a hold on Atkins.
Smart job right there by the defensive player.
Yeah, I think if you don't hold him, that's an easy score.
Yeah, because correct me if I'm wrong, Javi, in high school football, that's just a 15-yard penalty.
Yes.
It might even be offensive pass interference.
Well, it is.
Thought I saw the referee walking backwards.
Well, it will be exactly a 15-yard penalty crossing midfield all the way up to the 47-yard line. Do the Buccaneers, and they're going to swing it out. Atkins with the reception. Great job of running with the ball after the reception. Good yak yards right there, as they say. Yards after contact and up to the 40-yard line. Quick 7 right there on the quick pitch and catch from Brown. His favorite receiver, Lonnie Akinzum. They're going to swing it out outside. Akinzum catches it, makes a great catch, tries to elude a couple defenders, finally gets banged up from behind. The forward momentum gets him up to the 29-yard line. Another 11-yard pickup. That'll be another first down. The Buccaneers are quickly marching down the field as we quickly approach the 8-minute mark of the ball game. Raiders leading 28-7. Of course, it was 14-7 at the half. Two touchdowns by the Raiders in the third quarter has been the difference. And again, going to the bread and butter receiver is Brown. Akinzum with the reception to the 23. Gain of 6 now. Quickly up to the line of scrimmage. This time on the run, shaking it up on the play call. And the Bucs are get a first down up to the Raiders 16-yard line. Great play call right there. First down. Shotgun formation. They're going to keep it on the ground. Almost sneaking through. Shoelace tackle right there. Shoestring tackle by the Raiders.
Silas once again.
Mm-hmm. That could have been an easy score right there. From the 13. This time the play does work, and the Raiders just barely keep the running back out of the end zone. Let's see who that is. That is number 21 with the carry. That's Broderick Taylor. I believe that's Taylor's third carry of the ball game. Barreling his way down. First and goal on the ground. And the Buccaneers fighting, and they will score a touchdown. A great job right there finding pay dirt. And that is number 21, Broderick Taylor, getting his 8th touchdown of the season. And there we see the Buccaneers cut the lead to 28-13, pending the extra point. They will go for the extra point, trying to make it 28-14 with 6:45 remaining in the ball game.
Yeah, as much as you might think this game is over, I mean, you know, it really isn't. After that quick strike right there by the Buccaneers, mm-hmm. you know, and a gutsy call. Well, not so much a gutsy call, but, you know, you got to go for it on fourth down. You're down 21 points, and a great job by the Buccaneers. You know, picking up that first down, and with that score, it helps keep their season alive.
Yes,
just a little bit. Javi, you still got to stop a PSJ North offense.
Well, the Buccaneers go 75 yards on 11 plays. Of course, Taylor with a touchdown to cap it off. That cuts the lead in half, 28-14. 6:45 remaining. So now, John, do we see an onside kick, or is it too early? Of course, each team, I believe, still has all 3 timeouts remaining. Yes, they do.
Yeah, Javi, you know, it's your defense really, really has not been able to stop PSJ North running game. You know, they've rushed for 363 yards. You've given up 2 plays of 78 yards. And so it's a tough decision. Do you want to give PSJ North the ball with a short field if you don't come up mm-hmm. with the onside kick?
Right.
Or do you just not trust your defense? Again, you've given up 204 points on the season. So it's a tough decision, but I think you have to go for the onside kick here.
Well, we're going to see. I think the Raiders are expecting that indeed. And then with this win, that ball's going to bounce crazy as it falls off the tee.
And that's actually to your disadvantage, because if it falls down again, you're kind of forced to have hold the ball.
You're down one man, so to speak. Well, we'll see. And it will be an onside kick, and the Raiders can pick it up. They wisely do not. I thought number 12 was thinking about, you know what? Jesse Montes said, if I get it, I can outrun everybody for a touchdown. But I think he thought the better of it. And he said, you know what? I just better get the heck out of the way. And he did. The Raiders are going to have excellent field position at the Buccaneers 43-yard line.
Yeah, if you're PSJ North right here, Javi, you know, you really don't have to try and score. You're just going to try to to maybe get that play, that game clock to about 2 minutes. That, you know, it's going to be difficult to score, you know, two touchdowns, you know, with 2 minutes left. But PSJ North right here with a toss to Montes.
And Montes picks up good yardage past the 40. Let's see where they mark him down. To the 39-yard line. Pick up a four. Montes continues to do the job offensively. Montes now with 85 yards rushing on 18 carries. Ethan Guerra with 105, and, of course, Aparicio with 154.
I really think the difference has been the fact that that PSJ North front line, Javi, has dominated this the trenches. And you know, in football, that's what it's about. Early on, Miller had 9-10 guys in the box. As we see here, Aparicio bounced one off, and he's going to take it to the house.
Touchdown, Raiders. And there we see a jubilant Aparicio excited. The fans are excited. The Raiders should be excited because they've got a golden opportunity here. Aparicio from 39 yards out gets the Raiders in the end zone once again, now with a commanding 34-14 lead with the extra point pending and 5:55 remaining in the ballgame.
You know, it's funny, Javi, because it's always somebody different in the playoffs for the PSJ North. You know, last year, I believe it was Montes that had a big.
Yeah, it was Montes. He wasn't a big contributor, and he came through.
He had over 200 yards rushing, and here we have Aparicio, who really averages about maybe 80 some yards of rushing with 193 yards. So a great job, you know, once again by PSJ North.
Well, the Raiders at the extra point, and as we mentioned, with 5:55 remaining in the ballgame, it is now PSJ North, the Raiders 35. Corpus Christi Miller, the Bucks, 14.
I tell you what, Javi, for the you know, once again, and I actually think he got wrapped up, or he got the initial contact was at the line of scrimmage.
Yes.
But Aparicio just such an elusive back, and you know, just a great job. And we've seen him since the beginning, Javi, since pregame. You know, he was just had a swagger to him. He's just a confident player. Just, you know, some might say he's a little cocky, but he has a lot of confidence, and he does a great job, and he can prove it. He just showed it to you right there.
Well, I tell you what, to be a quarterback, you better come in with a lot of confidence into an area around matchup, and that's exactly what he did. And again, you got to appreciate who Aparicio is. He's a 3-year starter. I mean, he came in as a freshman, and he did the job. Last year, he got hurt, missed the majority of the year, but he was back in time for the playoffs. And now his junior year, he's been electrifying, and the Raiders have a golden opportunity, a great chance. They're 5 minutes and 55 seconds away from getting back to the third round for the second year in a row. And realistically, a couple years ago, they may have gone to the third round. They won by district. They went to area. They had to forfeit. And who knows? Maybe it'll be 3 years in a row now. But either case, right now, the Raiders looking good with a 35-14 lead. And, of course, this is a proud production of KTRI.
Yeah, I tell you what, for the 4,400 viewers we've had online, they've had a great show. And that's just, you know, a testament. And I'm going to talk about it. We haven't talked about it in the show, but it's a testament to what PSJ does. You know, we have a great production team led by Mark. And you know, to be able to get the opportunity to come out here and call this game, it's definitely, you know, a great experience. And we weren't sure we were going to come out here, but I tell you what, it's a lot better out here than it is watching it on TV.
Oh, most definitely. You know, high school football in Texas is supreme, and we're getting a true glimpse of it this evening. You know, we're here in Corpus Christi, and, you know, both teams are playing extremely well. This is the area round. You know, the Raiders come into this ballgame 11-1, and the 11-0, excuse me, and the Buccaneers 10-1. So these are two fine football teams just really getting after it. And, of course, one advances, one does not. That's football for you. That's life. There are no participation medals out here. You got to earn it. And right now the Raiders with the upper hand, 35-14. The squib kick, this will give the Buccaneers that opportunity to finally return a kickoff. And the Buccaneers taking full advantage and barely tripped up. If not, that would have been very dangerous. Speedy number 6, Roderick Taylor, almost broke that one for a big one. And that's exactly what you were talking about earlier. You cannot give opportunities to the skill set that the Buccaneers have.
Yeah, you know, and I'm really surprised that the Buccaneers had not declined those kick out of bounds. That's what they did right there. They declined it, and they forced PSA North to kick to them.
So from the 47, great starting field position for the Buccaneers. Of course, this game long from over. Buccaneers have quick strike potential. They're going to wing it out. A good pass, and that is caught by Moreno, and Moreno streaks down the sideline. He's going to get pushed out of bounds, but not before he gets to about the 22-yard line. 31-yard pickup right there, and as I just said, these guys have quick strike ability, and they just showed it. Ground game. Greenwood. Greenwood. With a yard, 2 yards, up to the 20.
You know, I just feel like there's really not a sense of urgency from Corpus Christi Miller, Javi. You know, you get 31 yards on that last possession. Then you go and you run the ball for about 3 yards.
They're going to spot him at the 19 forward momentum. Quarterback, keeper, he's got a lot of running room. Gets out of bounds at the 17-yard line. Well, they're going to officially spot him at the 16, so good pickup. No, they're going to push him back to the 17. Third down upcoming. Third and 5. And, yes, you're absolutely right. You know, we're at the 5 minutes and 10 seconds remaining. Each team still has all 3 timeouts. A swing out pass, and that is dropped. That had touchdown written all over it, just not able to execute with the Buccaneers. They wish they could have had that one back because that had 6 written all over it.
Yeah, that's unfortunate, Javier. Now, you know, this is pretty much your season right here. You know, you don't convert on fourth down, and there's no opportunity no more.
So Brown with a good pass. Fourth down. This could be it for the Buccaneers. Let's see if they elect to call a timeout. They've got all 3 in their back pocket. They will not. They're going to gamble here. They're going to run it. They're going to pass it. What will they do? They're going to swing it out. A reception is made by Moreno. Moreno gets past the 10, down at the 9. Big time play right there. Brown pitching catch to Moreno. First down. Buccaneers are still alive.
Yeah, the Raiders are smartfully giving them those little inside routes, and they're just covering deep. And I would do the same thing. You know, I'd rather them, you know, have to get tackled inbounds and then get to the outside and get tackled out of bounds.
And a vicious hit right there. Wow. What a way to finish that tackle. Jesse Montes, a hitting machine.
I think him and his brother try to see who hits harder.
I think so. And here we go. And there's a good run. And then whack. Wow. And another vicious hit.
What a big hit.
That's Montes once again. Take it easy, Montes.
I'm telling you, Javi, he looks over at his brother and he flexes his muscle and he tells him, I can hit harder than you can, buddy.
Broderick Taylor saying, what did I do to make this man get upset at me? Montes is a hitting machine right now, and a touchdown pass just nearly caught. Again, just off the fingertips. That should have been 6. So 2 golden opportunities missed by the Buccaneers. I tell you what, they could have already have scored, and who knows where we'd be right now. Lady Luck sitting on the Raiders' sideline as 2 drop passes on this drive has really hurt the Buccaneers. They're facing a 4th and goal here. Heavy pressure, almost jumping off sides were the Raiders.
Yeah, that's only their 19th passing attempt.
And there's another pass in the end zone, and that will be incomplete. Intended receiver number 9.
It's going to be Denmon.
Denmon unable to make the reception, and that'll be turnover on downs. That is huge.
Yeah, and again, Javi, you know, going back to what I said, that's their 19th. That's actually their 20th passing attempt. That maybe they got away with
a little push
there. But, you know, nonetheless, the call was made. But that was actually Denmon's first
target,
yeah. So, I mean, you're put in a situation where you basically are expected to catch the ball. It's tough when you haven't had any receptions the whole game.
So it'll be 1st and 10 for the Raiders at their own 3-yard line. And, of course, the Raiders are a couple of first downs away from sealing the deal here, advancing to the third round, advancing to the regional semifinals, and that is Montes, the older brother, Jason Montes, picking up valuable yards right there, rumbling up to the 18-yard line, a big pickup of 15, a first down.
Javi, and you know, I've been kind of paying attention to the body language from Corpus Christi, and it just looks like they've been deflated, you know, for half of that third quarter. It's just every time they get some momentum, PSJ North just has an answer.
Well, you know, it's tough, Jonathan. I mean, you go down, you get stopped half an inch from picking up a first down. Raiders come back, get a big touchdown, and that's been the difference. And on this play, you know, the Raiders, again, trying to eat up as much clock. And you look back to the previous drive where they, you know, they had a fourth and goal come up empty. They had two passes that were dropped. They could have been touchdowns. So, you know, self-inflicted wounds and a little bit of luck. And right now the Raiders getting the job done. So a false start will push the ball to the 20-yard line.
I think they actually declined that.
Oh, line. They did, yeah, decline it. Yeah, they so they're going to take the play, second down. And eight upcoming. That's interesting. Buccaneers need a stop. Raiders need a first down. And the Raiders are going to be up to the 25-yard line. So a good 5-yard pickup, and this time the Buccaneers will call a timeout. That's their first with 3:02 remaining in the game. Well, Jonathan, this is big now. It's 3:02. You just called one timeout. You're left with two. It's the Miller team. In all essence, the Raiders pick up a first down. They can start pretty much going into victory formation with a 3-touchdown lead. They're up 35-14.
Yeah, it's tough, Javi. You know, you come into this game, you know, with, you know, I think that a lot of people doubted PSJ North. You know, you looked at that Miller team, at what they had just done. I mean, they put up 49 points in the first half of last week's game. They scored on their first possession. And I was reading some of the comments on Max Preps, and, you know, it was just, man, you know, Miller's never scored this fast. Miller's this, you know, and again, don't take. I'm not gonna take away any credit from it. It's a great football team.
Yes,
but
they are.
You have a PSJ North football team that has a bunch of guys who are 3-year starters. I think that's a big difference right there.
Yeah.
And I've said it before, and I'll say it again. The scary part is, Javi,
they're all coming back
next year.
That's fascinating, to be honest with you. And you know, the Raiders are not done right now. You know, they're well on their way. They got 3 minutes and 2 seconds. In fact, they're a first down away. It's a toss. Montes, is he going to get enough for the first down? I think he's going to get bottled up right about a half a yard shy of the first down. Well, they're going to spot him maybe a whole yard shy back to the 27-yard line. So it'll be 4th and 1. With 2:40 remaining, and I think you go for it, Jonathan.
I was about to say, if I'm Coach Kaufman and we see him with that gutsy call and that outside kick in the first kickoff of the game, I'm going for it, Javi. And you know whose hands I'm putting in? I'm putting it in Aparicio's hands.
Well, let's see if he fakes a toss, keeps it. Got a big, heavy offensive line in front of him. Clock keeps ticking, 2:15. They are going to keep it. With Aparicio, he's going to barrel forward. And as we quickly approach the 2-minute mark, that'll be a first down for the Raiders at the 29-yard line. Aparicio needed one. He gets two. Aparicio now with 195 yards rushing on 13 carries. And with 2 minutes exactly remaining in the ball game, the Raiders can pretty much put it in victory formation and start prepping, start getting ready for a big-time Valley tussle. Two big-time Valley programs, Brownsville Veterans Memorial and PSJ North, exclamation point right here. The Raiders rambling on inside the 30-yard line. Tackle down is Aparicio at the 26. That's a 45-yard pickup right there.
And I was actually about to mention earlier when he got those 2 yards, it's unfortunate Aparicio is not going to get to his 200 yards.
Well, he got it, buddy.
He's at 240 yards now, Javi.
Wow, 476 yards rushing, no passing attempts on the evening. I'm not sure if that's ever been done. Well, I'm sure it has in high school football.
Check this out, Javi. 476 yards on the night.
Yes.
That's their highest rushing yards of the season.
Wow. What a time to do it. As we mentioned, you know, the interesting thing is, John, we talked about it at the very beginning of the ball game. The Raiders couldn't really do much. That offensive line, we've, you know, very heralded offensive line. We say they're big, they're nasty. They had a fight on their hands. Buccaneers defensive front withstood as the time went on. That offensive line kept pounding. And because of that, the Raiders are kneeling it. The Raiders 35, Buccaneers 14. And we're going to have a timeout.
Yeah, you know, it's crazy, you know, thinking about, you know, usually in the second, third round, you know, they call it the Valley Curse, right? You know, anytime the team leaves a Valley, you know, you're going to lose against a team that's non-Valley. And, you know, Mackay won tonight. Harlingen won. PSJ North won. Edinburgh Vela in a dogfight. They're down 7-14, and we wish them, you know, luck.
Times are changing, buddy. Yeah, Times are changing.
And you know, just a great job by this PSJ North team, Javi. I can't commend the coaching staff enough. They prepared. They pretty much knew that that's just who they were going to play.
Yeah.
And talking to the guys, you know, whenever we would see them at, you know, different games, they would say, you know, that's a really good – and they always gave credit to Miller. They said, that's a tough team. They're going to be our toughest competition. But I tell you what, I think this game prepares them because Brownsville Veterans is no joke. That's a real good team too.
It's going to be two mirror images. We may not see a single pass in that ball game, and we may see 1,000 yards rushing in that ball game. Brownsville Veterans is on a mission. I tell you what, I'm nervous about them. I'm nervous about Brownsville Vets because they're juggernauts at running the ball. They are extremely tough. They run that old school, you know, misdirection. Everybody's going right. Everybody's going left. Who knows who has the ball? They're very tough to stop. And there we go, folks. The Raiders are one play away. Of course, we'll see what happens next week. Obviously, it's going to be in the Valley, and I'm sure it's going to be either a flip or a home and home. Hopefully, the PSGA Stadium, the Raiders win. It's a PSGA Stadium. If not, it'll be at Brownsville at Sam Stadium. Or who knows, maybe they'll go neutral site. Fuentes with the carry, Jaden. He stays in bounds, and the
I'm not sure who called the timeout there. I'm not sure if that was I didn't think PSA North – or excuse me, I didn't think Corpus Christi had any timeouts. But I think that was – oh, yeah, that was Corpus Christi that called their last timeout.
Well, Jonathan, you know – the Buccaneers have exhausted all three timeouts, and I believe it's the wishbone offense, maybe that Brownsville Vet runs. A good buddy of mine, perhaps you know him, Mr. Jaime Gongora.
That name sounds a little bit familiar.
And I believe we're getting information that Brownsville Veterans will host that ball game. Well, I hope we get the nod so we can go out there and if back whether we work it or not. And, of course, this is not work. This is a pleasure and an honor to represent PSG ISD here with KTRI. Hopefully, I'm sure we're going to be out there, Jonathan, one way or the other, either broadcasting or watching and definitely rooting for the Raiders to get to the regional championship next week against Brownsville Veterans.
Yeah, you know, and I'm real surprised here that you just don't need the ball, but it could kind of be one of those things because – you know, Corpus Christi said, hey, they called the timeout. We're going to run the ball, you know. And
Well, that should do it, folks. I think they stopped it just to reset the chains. Let me see what.
I think that might have was. That was actually third down.
It was third, yeah.
Or fourth down.
Fourth down, yeah. So they got stopped. That's why they ran the ball.
Hey, Javi, you know, and let's commend the crowd for PSJ North.
Yeah.
There's a big crowd, and I actually think there was more people from PSJ or the PSJ North side, but we're on the home side,
right?
Than here on the home side, and that side was loud the whole time, and you know, for braving the weather. Hey, we're nice and warm in here, and credit to our tech team, our guys who covered, they're out there in the cold, and you know, again, just a great job by PSJ North, and a big thanks to you know, Corpus Christi for hosting us here, and PSJ North, Brownsville Veterans next week. Javi, we can't talk about that game enough. It's
I'm excited. I tell you what, yes, you know, and I just want to say, you know, congratulations to Corpus Christi Miller, the Buccaneers. They've had a tremendous season. They, you know, fell short tonight. And, of course, as I always say, there's a winner, there's a loser. Somebody has to advance. Corpus Christi Miller, congratulations to you. You got great fan support, and we wish you the best of luck throughout this whole school year, and hopefully we'll see you in the near future in other sports, if not next football season, because I think they have a great program working out here at Corpus Christi. They're going to throw a deep one. That is going to be intercepted by Matamoros, and the Raiders will now have an opportunity to go into victory formation.
Yeah, it's just an exclamation point, Javi. And that's one thing I love about this PSJ North team. They're very unselfish.
That, yeah.
You know, we talked about, you know, when Aparicio got hurt last year, you know, Julius Arredondo stepped up. And he did a tremendous job leading him to the third round of the playoffs.
Yeah.
And, of course, they mixed in Aparicio in the playoffs. You know, but, you know, for Julius to come in and, you know, just – You know you're going to go block. I mean, that's basically what you're going to do. We don't throw the ball. We don't throw the ball very often here at PSJ North, you know. And so just to be unselfish and to know your role is just a testament as to what's taught over there at PSJ North and a testament to how special this group is.
It is a special group indeed. Winning the district championship by district champs. Now they're going to be area champs. It's their second year in a row going into the third round. They're going to face Brownsville Veterans next week in the regional semifinals with a chance to get to the regional finals.
Javi, I just mentioned Julius Arredondo.
There we go.
Taking that final snap. And, wow, that just a great game by PSJ North.
So the PSJ North Raiders will be victorious here in Corpus Christi. By the score, Raiders 35, Buccaneers 14. And, again, we want to thank everyone for listening to this telecast, this broadcast brought to you by KTRI, of course, PSJ ISD, and I think our camera crew, Matt, Edgar, did a great job. Of course, our production team did a great job. And, Jonathan, any last words before?
No, Javi, you know, I just really want to wish, you know, everybody a safe ride home, especially, you know, everybody that came from PSJ North. It's a long ride home. It's late at night. Weather conditions might be bad. And, you mm-hmm. know, just, you know, once again, congratulations, PSJ North. And, you know, congratulations to Corpus Christi Miller on a great season.
Well, Coach Kaufman, congratulations to you, your coaching staff, the Raiders. You're going to advance one more week of football at the very least. Regional semifinals next week. Brownsville Veterans, PSJ North. Mark Vasquez, Danny Ramos, thank you for your proud production. On behalf of Jonathan, I'm Javi Martinez. I hope you enjoyed the game. Good night. God bless and safe travels.